हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे इज 7th May 2021, ऑलमोस्ट 6 PM. सो इन द डे टाइम दिस हार्टी जेरेनियम दे वेर ऑल ओपन, बट नाउ ओनली आई वॉज एबल टू कम आउटसाइड एंड टू रेकॉर्ड. सो आई एम सीइंग दैट द बलून्स आर अबाउट टू क्लोज, सो आई एम नॉट एबल टू शो यू द opened one, but there are many and it was looking very pretty in the daytime. The Girard's Crimson, see the tag, Girard's Crimson, one already opened. This is not exactly orange, it is kind of orange red mix color. And I came on the left side to show you this azalea because I saw one bloom here. So this is on the left, this is on the left side of the that gray Japanese cut leaf maple. The previous one I sold, that is on the other side. So in front of it, I have planted in front of this pink rose close to that tulip whose beautiful days are gone almost. So here it is, I planted this dianthus. I find it very pretty. Quickly, I thought I will show you this area a little bit, how it is. So that is Asiatic lily. That is one day I planted hyacinth. Yeah, hyacinth I think it's named. Then see this delphinia growing very well. This is a hardy geranium I planted last year. That is Salvia mainite, looks very good. Then I wanted to show you this bicolor iris, which I have planted in a row there. I showed you, it already started blooming from yesterday, and this maybe it will open tomorrow. And opposite side of this, here see the spirea. I could not trim them, so I'm too late to trim and they are already full, so I don't feel like cutting them. But anyway, right side of that is, this is the orange color iris. So I just wanted to show you, see the bud, they are ready, maybe next week they will bloom. Then this is the iris. Then this is the purple white bicolor. I transplanted 90% of all the rhizome into my front side garden, but I left 2 or 3 rhizome and they again multiplied in these past 2-3 years. And this is the sorry, I was wrong. That is the bicolor purple and white blooming iris. This is the dark color. I forgot the exact name. But anyway, this is the dark, some people say black iris, but very, it is dark blue according to me, this one. So they are producing their, I mean they are ready with their buds. So next week maybe they will start blooming. This is the second spirea, and this is the pink color iris. Somehow those two I planted I think in 2014, and they bloom heavily. But this pink only when I planted the first year it bloomed a lot. Second year somehow the blooms are only few. And those are from Home Depot. This is not from Home Depot. So I don't know, it is about the spot or it's the quality of rhizome, I don't know. I'm just sharing my experience. Then that Euonymus looks so beautiful next to that. See, now I am seeing, because on the other side of the buds they are not, the flowers are not visible, but here see the flower buds are visible now. This is more, this is a little less, but that is also more. So they are also, that one also. So yeah, in the next 2 weeks maybe they will be in their peak of their bloom. Then on this side, I showed you that tiny baby. So I showed you that azalea. And then see now, they are starting to dry. The flowers are starting to dry a little bit. Or see this beauty. This was the first creeping phlox who bloomed fast and completely all of them. Now the flowers are starting to dry. So here see this hosta, my second favorite plant after the cotyledon maple. So the other day I showed you I think one iris only, yellow iris only bloomed. Now already I think the first one which bloomed, see, I think that one, the first one which bloomed, that dried. So the other, these are new, these two are new. Next I'll show you the bicolor yellow, so that it will be easy to compare. So let's go to the center circle. Just passing by, so I thought let me show you. This is the purple bloom azalea. So all the blooms are gone. According to me, they stay for many days, but I don't know, my soil is clay, that's why or what. I feel they dried quickly. And next to that is this the other day, I think only few leaves are there. See this hosta, the margins are golden yellow. See the margins are golden yellow. Next to that, see little bit, only one. In other place, more are bloomed, I'll show you. But let me show you little more. When the big leaf hosta, they open, how they look. See how they look. I'll show you the other one. See how they look. And the new done climbing rose with a lot of branches after being trimmed. I don't see any birds. Here see this beauty next to this, my limelight hydrangea. So this is the iris which is new to me, and I bought it from a nursery near Boston when we went to drop our son in October. Then this is I'm close to the peach tree. One of my friend gifted this one. I planted last year, growing very well. So close to that was my original flowering pear. Actually, when I planted that flowering pear, I did not know it is flowering pear. I thought it will produce fruit pear, thinking that I bought 5 years ago in 2014, I believe. And later I realized that, and I learned that is a flowering pear only. Still I kept it, thinking it looks very pretty, white bloom, and it looked pretty too. But I struggled a lot to protect this plant because I didn't have fence, and around that I put deer fence, which didn't work that well. Deer just come close and bent that plastic flexible net, and they are able to eat the new branch they come. So easily they can cannot pass the net, but when they push the net, they are able to reach the new branch and they are able to eat. So that's how they ate. That is my experience. So I think 3 years ago, in a big storm, the main branch, it broke. It's not me, the branch broke. So when the main branch broke, and then I thought, okay, then it is I got an opportunity to really remove the plant. And whenever I used to see the auxiliary branches coming from anywhere or base or anything, and then I used to remove that. They have again come new from the base. So when the flowering pier was there around it, I planted few iris. You see 1, 2, 3. I may be wrong, but I think each are different. I believe I did not plant the same color iris. I used to make sure that I will plant under each tree one color of the iris. So when I saw, I was just passing by and I saw this bloom, so I thought, okay, let me show you this also. I think, see, maybe I missed yesterday. I was it is still coming, so maybe tomorrow that will bloom. So there are three. I don't know, that noise is too big for the camera or what. So see this beauty. And when I caught that, so close to that, then when I got this peach tree, I thought to plant it next to it, so that my distance from each big tree, I have maintained some distance. So thinking that I have planted that peach tree here. And that is a plum tree. That also I planted 3 years ago. This is its third season. So this year I see nice branches. When the iris under that will bloom, I will show you. But now I saw this, so I thought of showing you this. And those are last year I planted butterfly weed, I think, that seed. So few came, and from maybe they self-seeded again and they came again this year. Then this European beech, black swan or weeping or some say fountain, there are many names I think of this. The way the branches are kind of downward direction, so based on that they have the names. So the leaves are completely opened, so I thought I will show you, because whatever the color you are seeing now, it is not hot summer, so that's why it is lighter. But with time, slowly they are very dark purple or kind of almost black color they turned into. So see this. And as I feel sharing everything so that you can learn, whoever is interested, this is the most expensive plant, $99. This is the most expensive plant in my garden. Then see this wisteria. I'm sowing because each day you will see some new. If you can see there are flower bud also. See, there are flower bud. This one. These are flower buds. Like that, they are also, I see some flower buds. See, there are so many flower buds. If you see so many flower buds. So interesting. See, now I am noticing. They are flower buds. See? So close to that I had planted, when I transplanted the creeping phlox here also, because my idea was it multiplies with years and they will be settled in the ground, and every year I can enjoy the beauty, thinking that, you know, two branches I tried to plant it as many places as I can. Of this wisteria inside the circle, I had planted, I think, first week of December, red color big bloom hardy hibiscus. So when I bought, there was no leaves at all, only these kind of dried branches I saw. But I knew about this plant, they are hardy, they saw their leaves little late, and it was in a very big pot, so I was 99% sure it will survive. That's why I covered with lot of mulch. In March I little bit I removed, in April I removed little more mulch, and now see the result. I can see, if you can see, that is the new branch. So that is the new branch. So I longed for this plant for many years. In our area I was not finding the correct color. The light pink color that I had seen many times, but I wanted a darker color. So this is a darker, I think, maroon, and little bit darker of the maroon in the center. So when I saw this, though it was too late, I thought I will take a chance, and I bought it and I planted it. My son and my husband was telling, "You are crazy." I said, "Yes, I am. I love my plants that much." Just behind, I was talking about that plant. So behind that, see this row. The other day I had shared you the story how I planted these, and now see so many birds. So many birds. So here it already bloomed. Yesterday actually I saw it bloomed, but somehow my video was not uploading. I never had this kind of problem. It took long time, and many times it failed. I don't know the reason. I am new, I am not very good in editing, so bear with me please. Then only I can share all my experience and whatever I know about plants. See this, lot of birds, flower birds. There I see two, but still they have. And this is the big head of this circle, the second circle, that is my center. Then this is the next to that is lawn, and then this. So see, this is the big one, still looks beautiful. And this is the pink portion, Veronica, coming out nicely. See the daffodils. So here, close to that brick, I am trying. Yesterday I showed some. You can see, oh my god, some animal made that hole. They thought I have planted some bulbs. See. So these are the seeds, you can see, right? These are the seeds, you can see. They are marigold, orange color marigold seeds. Just yesterday I have showed here, very close to that brick line. So that there will be orange border of... orange color border of the orange marigold, thinking that. So yeah, and this is the tulip, second head. The white one, behind that white one, see this. The anemone. So I think only the first flower has a lot of layers. The other one, you can see, I think only two layers of petals. Next to that, see the second creeping phlox. Then close to that anemone plant, here near the poppy plant, I had sown some seeds here, the wildflower seeds or whatever. It was a mix of seeds, nearly they say 2000 seeds were there in that packet. And except this plant, every other plant bloomed. So this plant, if anybody knows what plant is this, please let me know. I searched a lot in the Google, I could not find it. I don't know, this barking sound, dog barking sound, sometimes I hear in my recording are very loud, but I can't do anything. Some people love their pet so much that they forget how its effect is to the neighbors. Anyway, so that plant, I don't know what plant it is. It did not bloom last year, but the uniqueness of this plant is it survived the winter. The whole winter, wherever this plant, like I have sown this, the seeds of that packet into multiple places to know which places they like it. So in every place, like few kind of seeds I sown, so almost every place there was one or two plant like that. And everywhere that plant survived the winter. In winter, other than Christmas tree, I was seeing this plant green. The leaves did not dry. So they are so hardy. I do not know the name. Please help me if anybody knows the name. I'm so curious to know what type of plant is this. This is my, I showed you one day, I made a video when before trimming this plant. This is a dark pink multi-layered hardy hibiscus which I bought from Christmas tree. And just when I was searching more space to sow the orange marigold seeds, I was cleaning little bit base of that plant. So when I saw it is empty and I can use it, so I sowed some orange color marigold seeds. So I sowed a lot so that I can transplant it somewhere else, but right now, and I did not add any compost. I was in hurry and I just did it whatever. This is my white azalea. Let me read the tag again. So Delaware Valley White, that's what it says. Let me put this back because the other one has no specific name in the other tag. So this is the, and oh yeah, I was thinking it bloomed but it didn't, but now I see one bloom. See, sorry, yeah, see. Then next to that white in this row here, this is a rhododendron. Nothing, because it was the tip was damaged in the winter. Then here I had sown some seeds. And the other day I said same seeds I have sown here, and I see some seedlings, if you can see. Yeah, I see some seedlings because after I sowed the seeds there was rain, so they got wet. Here also I see some seedling. So here also I have sown some seeds, but this is a different variety than the other one. But I came here to show you. See this hardy geranium filled with a lot of buds. I think among all my hardy geranium, the yellow, this is the most healthy looking and biggest, I mean, clump. Next to that, this is also, but it is a little smaller than that. So the other day I was showing you and see this beauty. So I think with time they fade a little bit. See this flower, but they are very pretty, right? I love this color, but I already had this color. So see that one also. But it is supposed to be this color. It is supposed to be this color. Then I am here close to that azalea. This is one nine bark. And here I have planted, behind me is the gala apple. And close to this, towards west side of the gala apple. Last year I planted this grape. So this is my second grape. The first one I have planted there, which is 3 years old. So this I can say 2 years old. Last year I planted, and their vines grew fast in my experience, what I see. This one and the other one. And I am not sure, but I feel I am seeing tiny grape, bunch of grapes. I think I may be wrong. See, do you see that? Do you see that? Do you see that? I think that is a grape. You see? Let me zoom a little bit. And then you see that? That grape, right? This one? This one? I'm sorry if it is a baby branch, but I feel it is grape. See here? Isn't it grape? They are not grape, they are grape, right? Because here you never know what hormone they give and the fruit comes fast. I'm thinking, I may be wrong, okay? But I find it interesting. And then I am close to that Paliwan lilac. I will show you the buds. Close to that Paliwan lilac, this row of spirea. So behind this row of spirea, you see those black compost, that black compost. So I have sown some red pepper seeds, which is like from the 200 pepper we bought to cook. That seed one day I just saved it and it dried. So I thought, let me try if it will work, work, if it will not, not. So thinking that, I have sown here some, so I'm sowing it. When there will be seedling, I can show you. So behind this, that is a blackberry. I planted 3 years ago. When I planted, I did not know it is a vine. And I gave small support, like 6-7 feet of circular support, circular wire, but it did not work. They bent, and the stems are so long, they were falling like this. So somehow I removed that support to give a stronger support. So that's how this is the situation. You see, if you can see, it's the branch, how far it goes. So I made them like that way. So this is the blackberry. Last year it produced some. Then here is my Paliwan lilac. See, filled with buds. They have nice fragrance. Not now, they are not open, so there is no fragrance right now. But I think tomorrow or day after tomorrow, maybe they will start blooming. So that is another hardy geranium, and that is one Asiatic lily. So see the geranium, I did not know they are so strong, these geraniums. I mean, I don't know if they are native to our zone. Then I came to show you the Sensation Deluxe. This is the first year of bloom, because last spring I planted, and there is one flower head. So if you notice, see the petals, they are bicolor, the margins are white, and so just as a different variety I collected, otherwise I believe the fragrance are same. So now, because I saw grapes in the other vine, so I thought, let me see this, and if I am not wrong, I am seeing grapes. Are they? If that is grape, maybe. It is so exciting. See? And I was telling my husband that cut them all, because I have seen in YouTube that they cut it completely, almost like leaving 2-3 height the branch, and then they get a healthy branch and lot of fruits. But we did not trim it at all, because I told him, wait, I have to learn how to do it, and then only we will cut it. And he was telling me, let it 1 year and then see if you will not get fruit, maybe next year you will trim it. So thinking like that, we did not cut it. I'm searching if I can show you. See, don't you think that is, those are grapes, right? Don't you think that is grape? Oh, am I focusing properly? Maybe not this one. Yeah, now. You see, they are also. Anyway. Yeah, just for fun, you know. I remember the day I bought it and I wanted to plant it. My husband was telling, do you really hope that you will eat the grape? I said, I don't know, let me try. I thought from this direction, if I can show you better view. See, I believe they are grapes. Anyway. It is interesting.
Then I came here to show you the bloom of my bleeding heart. Last year I planted, and after a month of planting, they looked dead. Their branches died. I thought it died. That's why I bought new roots this year and I have planted. But again in March, after I bought the new roots, I saw new branches coming out from the base of this plant, and it survived. I was surprised. And yesterday I saw this bloom. See if you can see. So this is my first bleeding heart bloom, only one. See, it bloomed only one, and two more are there. So I think I will stop it here. That's it for today. Thank you for watching.